Hey Adira, such a pleasure to have you. Thank you for managing some time to have this chat before our upcoming event on accent neutralization on 10th of this month. Adira Rodriguez, as the name states, bold and beautiful, a passionate and seasoned professional with a decade experience with brands like Accenture, McAfee, Wipro, Intelsat, and of course, with CII. It's been a lovely journey with you, Adira, and I'm so proud to have you as a part of this CII family.
Roshni, I'm also absolutely excited about this entire venture that both of us are getting into. It takes me, the time that we started working together and where we have reached right now, we have come a long way. And I owe so much to you for learning so many things from you. And I'm glad that we are on this forum at the moment. So I hope that we take this further for both of us.
Of course, yes. I think this one event today and the webinar coming next with you, I see a lot coming up for both of us. Now, a couple of questions before this event unveils on 10th. Adira, with such tremendous, vast experience with so many companies, how has the importance of pronunciation changed over the years?
Roshni, what a beautiful question this is. How has pronunciation, the importance of pronunciation changed over the years? Let me just say this, that earlier we used to get surprised if someone who we didn't expect and they knew English, all right? If you were traveling in an auto and if the auto guy just said, "Madam, do you want me to take a right or do you want me to go left?" And we would be like, "Oh, bhaiya, aapko English aati hai." And we would be like, "You know what, this auto driver knew English." So earlier it was about the fact that you knew the language. And people were given a lot more respect if you knew English. And that was the kind of respect we had for people who knew the language. But today, all right, today we see pronunciation is a representation of you and your English speaking skills. Pronunciation is not like the other skills. It strikes the listeners directly in their face, the ears to be more precise. How good your pronunciation is in general can be judged very quickly, and opinions can be formed instantly by anyone who hears you. Although we all know we should not judge a book by its cover, but we still do it unconsciously all the time. I think in general, we tend to overestimate people who have bad pronunciation. Let me just rephrase that. I think in general, we tend to underestimate people who have bad pronunciation and overestimate people who have good pronunciation.
So true. I completely buy that. Several experiences professionally and personally.
So Rosh, I also know that you have been in this industry for such a long time. You are one of those pioneers who have set the trend for a lot of entrepreneurs, in fact. You have worked in and out with people who come with different levels of competency, all right? But I'm sure you would have also met the ones who have a lot of mind block regarding their self-development, especially when it comes to pronunciation. So they might be good with their grammar and their vocabulary, but the pronunciations are not up to the mark. And they're not either moving forward to take up some course on it, or they're not trying to come up with an action plan to work on it. So what is the mind block, do you think, you have come across around with people?
That's very true. And that's something that has occurred several times in several projects, and the journey still continues with this idea of as you talk about mind blocks that people have when it comes down to pronunciation. This question helps me recall my experiences during my schooling and during bachelor's. I was bullied by a majority of my classmates, schoolmates, and in the college with this idea, "You sound dramatic. Now, taking this and the mind blocks, I understand them so clearly. Azira, one of the main factors that I see here is they find it fake.
Yes.
They coin the term for a person who speaks correctly or pronounces words correctly with the right tone and intonation that this woman or this man is faking it. They sound dramatic. You are trying to ape an English speaker or native speaker. So this is the first technical mind block. Now, second would be for most of the professionals who say, I'm happy with the way I sound. I am technically qualified and I come with a major experience. So I don't need to sound correct. Yes. I'm a technical guy, I'm tech smart and I'm tech savvy. So I don't need to sound correct. But here I would like to add, gone are the days where even technical support teams or leaders, business leaders could say so and get away. With the increase in projects over the years with CII in terms of accent neutralization, I would professionally and personally tell you that today, even companies set a benchmark and tell the teams very straight, get your pronunciation fixed. So these two major mind blocks are putting many professionals away from their own opportunities that they could have.
Just to add also to that, Roche, you might be good with your grammar, vocabulary, but if your pronunciation is the weakest of your skills, it's bound to have a big impact on how you're perceived by others. Since this is a very important for both private, your social situations, or even your professional or business situations. Focusing more on pronunciation is usually a good idea to start off with.
I wouldn't agree more. When you talk about social circle, let me give you a simple example. When you walk into a restaurant and place your order, if the steward is unable to understand your order, it's very hard. So gone is English and your communication there, irrespective of the industry that you cater to.
Right?
And let me talk about the calling industry with most of the Indian speakers facing a problem with numbers. 13 and 30 is so big competition while people speak. So I definitely say yes. Social circle are professionally goes for a toss if you are not going to fix that part of you.
Yes, absolutely true.
And that reminds me, Azira, why pronunciation matters more than you think today?
Well, Roche, first of all, the first thing that comes to my mind is it helps you to create smoother relationships with people who are English speakers or business contacts. You feel a lot more comfortable. They are also comfortable to understand you. Today, today the kind of collaboration that we have, it's no more restricted to only your region. We're also talking to people from the US or from the UK. There's a whole lot of interaction that's going on. And if you're going to be a little hesitant and if they're not able to understand what you're trying to say, either the person is just nodding to you just to make you feel that he's with you, but actually the person has been switched off and is just waiting when the conversation will end. Or maybe they're just looking at your expression and because you are smiling, so they feel that it's okay, it's a positive conversation. So let's just go ahead with, yeah, I know. But I'm sure the thoughts are like, you know, what is he talking about? And a lot of professionals, if they're not able to understand you instantly, they just switch off. And they might not be, they will not tell you upfront that, you know, I can't understand, it's very hard to understand you, it's difficult. They will just go ahead with the flow. But next time, if you're in a conversation with them, they're going to be a little hesitant. And, you know, the impression is going to be is that I don't understand this person. So in a natural given context, people who are listening to you every day, probably they don't have a problem. They are used to your accent and the way you pronounce your pronunciation in your conversation. But the people who are talking to you for the first time, they have to adjust themselves. They have to really try hard to understand what you're trying to say. So it becomes a pretty much of a difficult task for the one-to-one conversation with you. And maybe your conversation doesn't really help to build you in a relationship as well. It just stays in a transaction of yes, no, or right, we will get this done. That's about it.
Absolutely, absolutely. I completely buy that. So what else do you have on your mind, Adhira?
So Roche, we have something, what we have in mind over here is to get our other friends, our people around us aware about the fact that how important communication, when we talk, everybody today is aware that communication is important, but all the aspects have to work together. Just not the grammar or the English or your vocabulary, but also another aspect that is your pronunciation. And for that, Roche, we have planned for a session and we're looking forward for the 10th of July to speak to our audience, to tell them as what they can expect in this session and how they could look at pronunciation, because we still have people who say, I'm content, but they're talking about a content. All right, so.
Oh my God, that reminds me, 99% of the IT today, which has hit even management, I have been correcting innumerable professionals' content and content.
Yeah.
That's a big challenge. You talk to any professional and you say, I will send you the content. We are talking about the content. With these small words, with these small words and the difference that it makes to the listener, because the listener, if fortunately or unfortunately, the great speaker would have different definitions to that term.
Absolutely. No.
Well, anyways, not taking much of your time, I wish you luck for the upcoming event. And I'm sure with your tremendous experience, the audience would have a lot to learn from you. Thank you, Vera, and have a great day.
Thank you, Roshni, and you too have a great day. Bye-bye.